Akash Arora
and Aratrika Lodh
are delighted to be your hosts for the evening.
The world has advanced in every field. Science, technology, medicine, healthcare, transport, communication, the lot. Yet, countries are still at war. People suffer hunger, poverty, sickness, and are homeless and lonely. Destruction and devastation of precious resources, land, air, water, flora, and fauna are rampant. Everything seems out of control.
If we could sit in silence and ponder these issues, searching for a root cause, a point of origin of it all, we would finally be staring in the face of a tiny but terrible word indeed. G-R-E-E-D. Greed. We are all takers, very few givers. An intrinsic, baser human quality that seems to have overtaken our every other sense and sensibility, spurring us to want more and more and more at any cost, pushing us to take and take even what is not rightfully ours.
We seek to examine this feature of selfish greed of the majority who take and the very few who give through a collection of simple folk tales that would indeed delight you, but also engage and make you ponder. They have been drawn from five continental groups, each with a uniquely different culture and language, yet suffering the same affliction.
Our first tale comes to us from the South Sea Islands of Oceania. A silly little dispute between the creatures of the sea and the birds of the air, which spirals out of control and becomes a matter of life and death. Enjoy the presentation by students of grade 6, a test of numbers.
Dispute very much like this, between a whale named Dipa and a little sandpiper named Pippa. A silly mix of greed, ego, and utter foolishness snowballed into a battle which went out of control and posed a danger to the earth itself.
Huh? Huh?
Big enough for all of us, sea creatures and birds alike.
We must be friends if we have to survive.
So, the sea and the land creatures called a truce, which they both accepted and uphold.
Second tale comes to us from the lush forests of the Amazon in South America. Seeking domination over neighboring lands, a ruthless warlord and his henchmen drive the people to war, destroying much of the terrain and its resources. All seems lost, but there lies a spark of hope in the human spirit. Students of grade 7 present The Fire.
A long time ago, in the lush green forest, along the basin of the Amazon River in South America, there raged a terrible war between two groups.
This war was the creation of a Brez Ador, the fiery one, the evil wizard of the plains.
Though he enjoyed the overlordship of the plains, he wanted more. He wanted to also be the king of the forest.
He was a crafty one indeed. While he stirred up trouble between the groups, he took the help of Riqueza, the wealthy one,
and Potencia, the powerful one,
to bring the trouble to a boil.
Listen carefully! Those rascals on the other side have been saying
that you are good for nothing and want to take your land and everything in it.
I knew this was going to happen.
Miss, you can't trust them anymore.
What do we do? They must act fast.
Yes, we must act fast.
I just came down the river and guess what I saw and what I heard.
What? What is it?
Those schemers on the other side have been saying that you are responsible for the destruction of the forest and have no right to be here in the first place. They seem to be preparing themselves for something big. I saw big sticks and
boats
and machines.
Show them that who is to stay and who is to go.
Yes, 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 yes.
The forest should by right be ours.
Yes, yes, yes.
My able generals, Potencia, the powerful one, and Rikiza, the wealthy one, will explain to you everything you need to know so that victory is yours.
Yes, yes, yes.
Sell them to you at a fraction of the market cost because you are good friends of a boss. Imprisoner the fiery one!
Yes! Imprisoner the fiery one!
Yes! Anything to destroy the enemy!
Onwards to victory!
What are you doing? Why don't you move faster? I hear the enemy on the other side are getting the latest armaments to use against you.
Then can we get even better arms, bigger and more powerful to destroy those brutes on the other side?
Yes, 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 yes.
My able generals, Potencia, the powerful one, and Rikiza, the wealthy one, will explain to you everything you need to know so that victory is yours.
I have the very latest armaments, guns, bombs that will destroy your enemy in no time.
We could sell them to you at a fraction of the market cost.
Market cost?
Because you are good friends of our boss.
Impressor, the fiery one.
Yeah! consuming everything. Land, vegetation, inhabitants, air, water, everything. In endless columns of fire, as guns and bombs screamed and roared all around.
It was a terrible sight to behold, as no one and nothing seemed to have been spared, including the warring groups. All life seemed to have been snuffed out, reduced to ashes.
But wait, something moves.
It looks like one solitary survivor from the people on that side.
No, there's another crawling in from the other side.
Look, boss, looks like people. Two of them.
I thought we were the only ones who made special survivor arrangements.
Wait, who are you? And where did you miserable creatures come from?
I am Carlos. And this is my wife, Isabel. She lived in the city section on that side. And I worked in the forest on this side. When the terrible war began, we went and hid in a cave deep down in the earth where the terrible fire and the destruction could not reach. Now, we have come out in search of food and water.
Very enterprising of you both. But look all around. There's nothing left. How do you like it? Enjoy your last moments. Soon, you too shall die.
We do not have to die.
We will live.
Worse for you if you do. A pathetic existence. Dying of hunger in this deathbed of dust and ashes.
The land is dry for now.
True.
But it will rain.
Rain?
Did she say rain?
We said it will rain.
And I have seeds. We will plant. Food will grow once again.
Goodness outlasts everything.
Thank you.
from Russia. For a poor struggling fisherman and his wife, good fortune comes in the form of a magical bird who provides them food enough to eat and to make a living. The local ruler hears of this and wants the bird for himself. The fisherman, thinking it would lead him to endless wealth, agrees to help capture the bird for a princely package. However, his plan backfires and he is left with nothing. Students of grade 8 present Bird of Wonder.
Stand housework. You just do what you do and you do it so well. For now, just sit. I shall pour you some water to drink.
I always thought we could sit for a while by a warm fire, drinking some hot soup and freshly baked bread. But that's just a dream. All we can afford now is some water from the stream and bits of yesterday's bread. And you do add an occasionally fishy surprise.
When I catch some, but now even the fish are too few to bite. All I got for the day's catch were a few small minnows.
Don't worry, my dear. I am sure you'll have a good catch tomorrow. Tonight we are blessed with a roof over our heads and some water to drink. Let us enjoy a restful night with dreams of brighter and better tomorrow. And more than just two tiny fish.
Thank you. market where I can sell them. If I get a good sum, then I can buy some bread for my wife and myself. That is all I can afford.
My good man, you seem to have a good heart. I would like to help you and your dear wife, if you allow me.
I am filled with wonder, beholding one so beautiful as you. That reward is enough. But at the same time, any help will be accepted with utmost gratitude.
Go home, good man. From now on, I shall bring you a bag full of fish every night. You can sell them at a good price. Then you and your wife can live in comfort and won't have to work so hard anymore.
Lala, sweet Lala, my dear, you shall never believe this.
Oh, yes, I can. 2 whole fish at good dinner tonight.
Ah, yes. Here you go. Take the fish. But wait. Hear this.
What?
So there was a wonderful.
Really?
Yes.
That is so
awesome. Did she give you the fish?
Yes.
Thinking so, I would be betraying the very bird which saved us from poverty and hunger, give us a life, everything. On the other hand, just imagine how the entire kingdom. I am Vladimir, a fisherman. Take me to the emperor at once. I can tell where the cupboard can be found. His Majesty, Emperor Ludwig. Vladimir, a fisherman.
Fisherman.
Same thing.
My good man, I hear you are eager to help me. You see, I am suffering from a certain malady of the big toe, and no medicine has so far helped me. But I am told that I can be cured if I eat the flesh of the Kaha bird. You must help get up for me, and I will reward you handsomely.
I am shocked to learn that the emperor intends to kill the magnificent bird. But if I don't help him catch her, then someone else will, and so merit the reward. Why should I lose this chance?
Your Majesty, the Kaha bird visits my home every single night, giving me a bag full of fish.
Excellent! Then you must have get her for me.
I am honored to help your Majesty, but I must also add that the Kaha bird is very big and strong. I can't catch her on my own. It would take more than 20 men to hold her down.
Then I will send 50 of my men with you. Hide them under the tree where she sits, and they will do the job.
No, no, no. That would never work. She can never be caught that way. We have to think of a way to trick her.
Well, what do you have in mind?
I know. I must get her to come down to the ground first. I shall pretend to invite her to dinner. When she comes down to dine with me, then perhaps she can be overpowered.
Excellent! You are a very smart person indeed, fisherman.
Fisherman.
Same thing.
We shall do it your way.
So, on that fateful night, preparations were made. A feast was laid out on the ground, in the yard, outside our house. And 50 men sent by the emperor hid in the darkness of the nearby trees.
Ah, my beautiful coward! See what I have laid out for you. A gorgeous feast to thank you for all you have done for us. Please do us the honor of joining us.
Oh,
tale comes to us from our very own land of India. A simple villager in need of money is forced to take his cow to market, hoping for a generous buyer. On the way, he is tricked by a pair of cheats who pay him a paltry sum, but later sell the cow to another for a huge sum. Stung by the injustice, he uses his ingenuity to enter their home, recover his money, and teach them a bitter lesson for life. Students of grade 9 present Sher Ko Sawa Sher.
कहानी एक गांव की कहानी ना राजा ना रानी भोला और चंदा की कहानी
ओहो भोला और चंदा की कहानी
बोला का बात है भैया काहे इतना उदास दिखत हो
का बताएं भैया लागत है डूब जाएगी नैया
खेत का कर्जा कैसे चुकाएं पास में है बस एक हो गैया हमार मुनमुन गैया
अरे चंचल उठ जाओ बेटा
आवत है
मोहन सोहन दो है भैया धोखा देते सबको दैया
भोला के संग देख के गैया खिल गई उनकी बात है भैया
काहे दैया
देखो मैया
नमस्ते भैया सवेरे सवेरे कहाँ जात हो
का दिक्कत है गैया को मॉर्निंग वॉक पर ले जात है का
कौनो परेशानी दुख है तो हमें बताओ समाधान हम बताएंगे तो नहीं खुश हो जाऊं
कर्जा चुकाने खातिर गैया आपन मुनमुन को लाए हैं 500-700 रुपया में चली जाए तभी सुख पाएंगे
ई गैया और 700 रुपया बड़ा जुलुम है भैया 100 रुपया ले लो और दे दो आपने गैया
100 रुपया 100 रुपया में ऐसन गैया तनिक शर्म करो भैया
ए भैया
आ भैया
तनिक यहां आओ
बोलो
ई गैया का दाम तो लगाओ
गैया ए 50 रुपया भी बहुत है
ना भैया ऐसे ना कहो यही एको संपत्ति बची है
अरे तो का हम लुट जाए 100 रुपए में गैया दो या कि हम जाए
100 रुपया में हम का करेंगे कर्जा कैसे चुकाएंगे लेकिन कर्जा चुकाने खातिर अब ले लो भैया
ये लो भैया
सिर्फ 100 रुपया पाए हैं
का सिर्फ 100 रुपया तुम बहुत ही भोले हो हम 100 रुपया में का करेंगे हम कुछ ना जानत हमें हमार मुनमुन वापस चाहिए
अच्छा तुम शांत हो जाओ हम जाते हैं
अरे ओ भोला भैया
कोनो काम बना का
ना भैया कोई मोहन था हमसे हमार मुनमुन सिर्फ 100 रुपया में ले गया
सिर्फ 100 रुपया में तुम्हार मुनमुन चली गई
हाँ भैया
फिर तुम हाट काहे जात हो
अरे चंदा कही थी कि मुनमुन को वापस लाओ तो हम जाते हैं
ओहो ये तो बड़ा ही जुल्म हो गया
हाँ बसेसर कोई लूट गया।
और गुलबिया पता है कोई लूट गया?
देखो देखो दोनों भाई मजमा लगाते हैं
और कौड़ी से खरीदे का ऐसे मुनाफा भी कमाते हैं।
देखो देखो
अरे आओ हेलो आओ भैया देखो देखो सुंदर गैया
दूध दही की नदियां बहाए दाम है इसका 700 रुपया।
हाँ भैया
ये गैया और बस 700 रुपया
और का
दे दो भैया
पैसे तो दो
लो भैया
ले जाओ भैया
आ तो हमारी राम दुलारी बहुत ही खुश होगी।
अरे भैया ये दोनों तो बहुत ही दुष्ट और स्वार्थी हैं। ऐसन कपर तो हमरे साथ भी किए थे ई दोनों भैया।
ई दोनों भैया हैं?
अरे हाँ ई दोनों तो भैया हैं। भोला नाम सुनकर भूल कर गए हो ई बैसन बम का गोला बनब कि याद रखेंगे जन्म जन्म। भोला नहीं अब बनकर आऊंगा बिल्लू बादशाह और बजाऊंगा दोनों भैयों का बाजा। हाँ भैया चलो अब इन दोनों भैयों को सबक सिखाते हैं। अरे ओ चल चल बेटा आओ।
नमस्ते भोला चाचा का हाल चाल बड़े ही दुखी दिखा तो।
बेटा हमरे घर जाओ और अपनी चाची को बताओ कि हम दो दुष्ट लोगों को सबक सिखाने जाते हैं।
जी चाचा अभी जाते हैं।
अरे गुलबिया जेता गजब हो गया अपना बोला बाला बोला बम का गोला हो गया।
हाँ बसेसर देखो अपना भोला क्या गुल खिलाता है और मोहन सोहन को छट्टी का दूध याद दिलाता है।
गाय के दूध के अलावा छट्टी का भी दूध होता है।
अरे भैया तुम तो जाओ।
बढ़िया हाथ मारा है
पूरा साल का हो गया गुजारा है।
अरे भैया पैसे तो छुपा लो।
छुपा लो।
बोला अब तैयार है अपना वार करने को।
मोहन सोहन भी हो तैयार अब सब भुगतने को।
भूख लगी है बड़े जोर की खाए क्या हलवा पूरी।
दिमाग बहुत चलाए हैं हाथ पैर अब ना चल पाएंगे। अरे कोई खाना बनाने वाले को तो बुलाओ अपन तो बैठकर खाएंगे।
कोनो काम मिलेगा का काम
आज प्रभु भक्त ही खुश है।
आओ आओ खाना बनाना। अरे रसोई करना जानत हो?
नहीं हल चलावे खातिर ही आए हैं। धत रसोई कहाँ बनावे?
वहाँ उधर बढ़िया पकवान बनाना।
अरे घर में सब है या बाजार से कुछ है लाना?
और का नाम बताया अपना?
बताए तो नहीं लेकिन सब हमें प्यार से रानी बुलाते हैं।
ये लो
सब्जी ले लो सब्जी ले लो।
टमाटर है का?
अरे हाँ है ना।
अभी गरम गरम खाना बना के ला।
ओहो बसेसन कहानी में अब ट्विस्ट आ गया।
ये ट्विस्ट ही बिल्लू बादशाह आ गया। बिल्लू बादशाह कौन बिल्लू बादशाह?
भैया बहुत चोट लग गई है कोई इलाज मिल जाए।
भैया कोई भीतर है का?
कौन है हुआ?
हम वैद्य बाहर खाली जगह पर दुकान जमा ले अपनी दवाई की।
आज प्रभु बहुत ही खुश है।
आओ आओ और दवा लगाओ।
अरे ये क्या हो गया?
अरे कोई रानी थी हमारे लिए खाना बनाने की जगह हमारा ही खाना बना गई।
ओहो।
अरे रानी नहीं बिल्लू बादशाह था।
अच्छा भैया कहाँ कहाँ मारा? यहाँ मारा।
दक्षिणा
आज प्रभु बहुत ही गुस्से है। गुरुजी गुरुजी
हटो यहां से।
देखा नहीं जी
हाथ दिखाओ बच्चा हटो। बड़ा ही बुरा वक्त चल रहा है। तुम्हारा तो उससे भी बुरा वक्त चल रहा है। अच्छा अच्छा अच्छी है का
Our next tale comes to us from the native tribes of North America. A village stricken by famine seeks every insincere way to appease the weather gods, but are unsuccessful. They suffer from sickness and death of many. A little orphan girl offers her only possession, a rag doll, as a sacrifice, and their prayers are finally heard. Students of grade 11 present, in a unique group recitative style, the legend of the Blue Bonnets.
Back, back, back in time. Long, long ago, before the first white person set foot on that continent, the people called Comanche lived and hunted in the southwestern corner of what is now the United States. They moved over the countryside, assembling their teepees where the supply of water and buffalo were plentiful. But there came a time when a great drought visited the land, drying up the streams, destroying the grass on which the buffalo fed. Until, finally, there was little water, sparse vegetation, and no buffalo. It was a time of famine, a time of death. The first to die were the sick and the weak. Next, the old people died. Then many, many of the children. Before long, there was not a teepee in the village where death had not stopped. One child who did survive was she who is alone, named such by her people because only she of all her family still lived without mother or father, uncle or aunt, brother or sister. She lived alone. Her only companion was a doll. A doll made of cloth and feathers from the blue jay. A doll made by her mother before she died. The doll became her mother and father, uncle and aunt, brother and sister. Time passed, but still the drought remained, and still the famine fed on the blood of the Comanche people. The shaman said,
"Let us dance! The dance of the rain to beg the great spirits for relief."
And one man responded,
"But we are weak from lack of food. What kind of dance could we offer?"
And the shaman replied,
"The dance of those who dance though weak is a dance that the great spirits will smile upon."
So they danced. For 3 days they danced.
the great spirits will smile upon.
So they sat. For 3 days they sang. And until they could sing no more, only she who is alone kept singing. But the spirits did not smile, and the rain did not fall. And the people huddled together in despair. Only she who is alone remained apart, clutching the doll that was her family.
Next,
the shaman said,
I will climb to the top of the mountain to beg the great spirits for relief.
And the warrior responded,
but you are too weary from dancing and singing to climb to the top of the mountain.
And the shaman replied,
it is the attempt of those too weary to try that the great spirits will smile upon.
And he left them. For 3 days he was gone.
On the third day, the people saw him in the distance, crawling towards the village. They ran to him.
Did you speak to the spirits?
What did they say?
Tell us, shaman, is there hope?
I spoke to the spirits, and the spirits answered.
We have given you water, and you drink. We have given you buffalo, and you eat. Everything we have given, you take, but nothing have you given back to the water, to the buffalo, to us.
I asked them, what must we give? And they replied,
you must give that which you would never want to give or be taken away from you.
But
what do we have of such value?
Surely they wouldn't want my beautiful cooking pot, for there's no food to cook.
Or my plow, for the land is too dry and nothing will grow.
One by one, the people left. Even the shaman, discouraged by the selfishness of his people, retired to his teepee. Only she who is alone remained apart, cradling the doll that was her family. Consuming the doll.
He wants by sheer dint of luck. When the chief of the village asks him to do a job, he tries to trick him. But his plan fails to work and he finds himself in a very desperate position. Presenting this tale are a courageous band of our very own teachers who seek to encourage our students by doing what it takes. We give you Chizoba and the Money Farm.
Hello, friend. Hi, friend. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Enjoy some peanuts, you know. This weather and peanuts.
I love
make
peanuts.
A good, they make a good combination.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm. It's delicious.
It is, I told
wow.
you.
Mm.
Have some more.
Mm.
What happened?
Hey, hey.
Oh. I don't
began. Chief Thimba. Chief Thimba ordered each of his animals to plant a certain crop.
Gwanda! Gwanda the warthog! Gwanda! I want you to grow yams.
Me? Yam boss?
Who boss?
You boss?
Me boss?
Your boss. Your boss.
Bawadne! Bawadne the lion! I tell you, this lion must be sleeping somewhere. Bawadne! I want you to take care of potatoes.
Oh, cool, Chief.
And Fudu. Fudu the tortoise.
Who called me?
It is I, your chief. From you, I want corn. Lots and lots of corn.
Okay, Chief.
And that guy. Chizo. Chizo, yes, Chizo. Chizo the rabbit.
I am a hare, not a rabbit, and my name is Chizoba.
Is that respect? Is that the way you speak to your chief? I get very angry when I'm disrespected.
Sorry, chief. Chief, but I got this great idea.
It is I, your chief, who will decide whether the idea is great or not. Okay? Tell me.
Chief, if you give me a bag full of money to use as seed, then I'll grow such a large crop of money from it that you will be rich.
Who are you trying to fool? I know that money don't grow on trees.
I know the secret.
Secret?
The secret that will make you rich, rich, rich.
Rich? Rich? Rich!
Take a chance, Chief. This is an offer you can't refuse. Easy money, huh?
The chief, attracted by the idea of easy money, decided to trust his Oba.
Yeah. Take this bag of money. You shall tend to the crops. And when it is harvest time, you shall bring back my money. Do not disappoint me. Disappointment makes me mad.
Don't worry, Chief. Very soon you are going to be rich, rich, rich. Like Ambani. Like Adani. Like Chizoba.
But Chizoba had no intentions of planting the money. Instead, he bought fine jewelry for his beautiful wife, expensive delicacies to eat, and beautiful dresses to wear. Let's see.
I'll show you.
Hey, Pipniani!
Coming, darling!
Just look at this, Armani.
Wow! What are you going to do when the harvest is in?
Don't worry, I'll think of something. Just be happy.
Oh, thank you, darling.
Soon it was the harvest time, and the chief sent for Chizoba.
Chizoba? Chizoba, come here.
Chief.
Chief!
Where is the money that you promised to grow?
Don't you know anything? Money is a very slow growing crop. Perhaps it will be ready by next year.
But the next year came, and the year after that. But Chizoba had no money to pay to the chief. Now the chief grew impatient.
Chizoba! Chizoba, come here! Chizoba! You are disappointing me!
Chief, but...
Wanda! Wanda, the warthog!
Yeah, boss! Yo!
You are the most trustworthy of all my animals!
Yeah, boss!
Who, boss?
Me, boss!
Who, boss?
You, boss!
Me, boss?
Yes, boss!
You shall go with Chizoba to the money farm and bring back my money!
Chizo! Chizo!
No, boss! No, boss!
Chizoba turned white in fear. As they walked along, he said,
Chizoba! Chizoba!
Warthog! I can't go on. Actually, I'm sick. I'm dying. And the walk is too far.
Quiet, will you? I have my orders. You have to keep walking. Walk.
Warthog! I just remembered something. Actually, I have forgotten my pillow. We will have to sleep on the road tonight. I'll be right back.
Chizo, if Chief Temba catches me, he will kick me and I will be like, pew, pew, pop.
No, no, I'll be right back. Keep going.
I'll get you out.
Chizo!
As we can see, Chizoba sneaked ahead of the warthog and disguising his voice, he shouted.
Just come along, fellow hunters. Just look at this monstrous warthog. Just carve him into succulent steaks and have him for dinner. There he is, over there. Everybody, let's have this warthog like a hot dog.
And Warthog ran home as fast as his stubby legs could take him.
What? I'm going to be someone's dinner before they catches me. I have to run. Mama!
Now Chizoba went to the chief and said,
Chizoba!
Chief, I can't imagine what happened. Something must have scared the warthog. He just took off like a rocket. He must be near Chandrayaan 2.
Huh? He really ran off? I think warthog can be moody at times. But what the name? But wasn't it a lion? You are the bravest of all my animals. You shall go with Chizoba to the money farm and bring back my money.
Cool, Chief. Let's go, long ear.
Chizoba started shaking with fear. After all, how was he supposed to scare the lion, the bravest amongst all the creatures?
Oh, lion. Lion. Actually, I forgot my shovel. That digging thing. But I'll be right back.
That's cool, dude. I'll just lie here and chill till you get back.
But be careful. They say that there are some evil spirits in this forest.
Are you trying to scare me? I know there are no such things as evil spirits.
Oh, well.
And the lion settled into an uneasy sleep.
Oh, look at those mosquitoes. Oh, they are so huge. Oh, they are coming over the hill. Oh, they are looking like a dinosaur. Are they going to have this nice, juicy lion?
These mosquitoes. I hate these mosquitoes. These bloodsuckers. I'm out of here.
that he ran like the wind.
And like always, Chizoba once again goes to the chief and narrates the entire event.
Chief, chief.
Really?
All out.
The mosquitoes scared him? Lion can be excitable at times. Fudu, Fudu the tortoise.
Yes, chief.
You are the most sensible of all my animals. You shall go with Chizoba to the money farm and bring back the harvest.
Okay, chief.
Now this time Chizoba was more in trouble. After all, a clever fellow like him could certainly outthink a slow-witted creature like the tortoise.
Tortoise. I just remembered something that I'll have to get my pillow. I'll go home and I'll be back in a minute.
That's okay. You can borrow mine.
Fudu, I just remembered that I'll have to get my shovel. It won't take me a minute. It's better that I go home and get it.
That's okay. I have an extra one just in case.
You carry everything with yourself?
Yes.
Oh, tortoise. Can't you hear some strange noises? Ooh, it's better that I go home and get my lucky charms.
Ooh. You are a funny guy, Chizoba, but you can't trick me. I saw your lips move.
No. Ooh. Oh, no. I'll be right back for you. Just take care.
Chizoba, get back here. The chief is not going to be happy about this. You know that? I am slow, but steady.
Chizoba, knowing that the clever tortoise could see through his tricks, ran to his hut to seek his wife's advice.
What?
Just help me.
What happened?
Just hide me. I cheated the cheat.
What?
I greeted the greet.
Oh, what are you saying?
I pitted the pit. Oh, no.
Relax. Oh. Now tell me.
They know that. I have cheated the chief.
You cheated the chief? It will be death for you.
No, please, you will have to hide me.
There is no place to hide.
No, there is so much of place. Yes, there is so much of place to hide me. Just pull out all my hair and pretend that I am your baby.
Are you crazy?
No, Pipniani, there is no other way to save me. Just save me, Pipniani.
All right. But this is going to hurt you badly.
Just do whatever I am telling you to do.
Okay. Bend down.
Bye. at my place?
Never mind that. Where is Chizoba?
Oh, that ruffian. I don't know where he is. As you can see, the only people here are me and my baby.
You must be knowing where he is.
I told you. I don't know.
Then you must be hiding him somewhere.
There is no place to hide, sir.
Well, in that case, I'll take the baby as hostage until the time you find Chizoba.
Oh, my precious Ruff. I mean my baby. Wait. Great Chief Themba, kindly allow me to say goodbye to my baby.
Well, hurry up. What was that sound?
Baby!
Take the baby!
And the chief left with the little baby as his hostage.
When Chizoba's wife went with the breakfast, she opened the blanket and cried aloud.
Chizoba! gentlemen, your hosts for the evening. A big hand to them, please.
We Arani,
Akash,
and Aratrika
are delighted and privileged to be your hosts for the evening.
Before our final offering, may we thank you all for being such a wonderful audience. And we wish you a peaceful and pleasant night ahead.
Our master chorus of 55 singers, cast members, and dancers will now bring the curtain down with another stirring song, which asks the challenging question, do we have the courage to change for the better?
How about that? I want to thank you all for this absolutely phenomenal performance on this final night. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for these much deserving kids? And a huge round for that choir that sang their heart out. Thank you, choir. Thank you so much. There is a huge team that it takes to put all of this together, but I want to introduce you to the one man who had the vision, who had the creativity, and the zeal to work with this group right here to make this magic happen. I want you to meet the director of the play. Can I request Stephen Marazzi to join me up in front? Stephen, you deserve so much more. Thank you for what you pour into these children and what we could see. Thank you so much. A small token of appreciation. Thank you so much. I know you've got a whole team, but I want to introduce our vice principal, Co-Scholastic Pia. I want you to be able to let everybody know the team that it took for you to put this together. To you.
Thank you, sir. First of all, I would like to thank our director, ma'am, and Dean, sir, for giving us this opportunity. I would also like to thank the assistant director, Mr. Tenzin. Can I have him here? So you can see the bonding the children have had with them. And all the logistics and administrative work was done under the leadership of our principal, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. And Bindu, ma'am, thank you. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank each one of you. And wonderful job by all the students. God bless you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Let us all now join in singing the national anthem with fervor and remain standing as the school colors are trooped out.